Texas at Texas A&M University, the monthly rainfall totals of 0.72 inches ranked as the third driest season. Never before has so little rain been recorded prior to and during primary growing season for crops, plants, and warm season grasses. Mr. Gammon said, it's just devastating. Then, as late as October 29, the Dallas Morning News reported without significant rainfall over the coming months, most of Collin County and most of Dallas and adjoining counties to the east could easily be out of available water for next summer. And then on this past Thursday, they pronounced and put into effect stage 3 restrictions. Now, this report gives us an idea of what was experienced in Israel after no rainfall for 3.5 years. Elijah, the prophet, had become jealous on behalf of God because Israel had begun worshiping the idol God Baal as opposed to the Lord God Jehovah. Now, this practice of Baal worship began to infiltrate Jewish religious life during the time of Judges 3:7, and now had become widespread in Israel under the reign of Ahab. You can read that in 1 Kings 16:31 through 33. And had also affected Judah, 2 Chronicles 28:1 through 2. In general, Baal was believed to be a god of fertility, God of the earth, who was able to send rain to produce crops and cause the people to produce children. Therefore, Elijah resolved to challenge this belief head on by standing in the presence of Ahab and announcing to his face that it would not rain for 3 years until he said so. And without waiting on a response, positive or negative, he walked out of the palace, leaving no forwarding address. Now, I'm reasonably sure that the king and his cabinet initially found humor in the old man's words. They perhaps thought him to be a deranged lunatic. The very thought that it was not going to rain in Canaan, in and of itself, was ludicrous. Oh, they were laughing about that, I bet. Especially knowing that God had made a covenant promise to their ancestors that it would rain without fail at least twice a year. Y'all not praying with me, That it would rain at least twice a year, It was supposed, God promised it would rain in the spring, which was the time of the planting. And then again, it would rain in August, which was the time of the harvest. And this promise is found in Leviticus 26 and 4, and Deuteronomy 11 and 14. It was called the former rain and the latter rain. And I submit that Ahab was like so many church folk today who claim selective passages of the Bible to fit their lifestyle. Y'all better pray with me. Even if it means that they take the word of God out of context. Therefore, Ahab embraced these passages in the positive about the rain, while neglecting those demanding his obedience, he put that in the negative. But God sent a prophet by the name of Elijah. to remind them of the whole covenant and the consequences of their failure to worship God only and to keep his law. Now, they might have laughed initially, but after a while and things started happening and livestock started dying and folk didn't have enough water to do what they needed to do, he stopped laughing. As time went on and things progressed and got worse, he became so worried that he and his men went out searching for water just to save his livestock. But in the meantime, God had made provisions for Elijah. Oh my God, that's the kind of God that we serve. Not only did he make provisions for him to eat bread and meat, but he made provision for him to drink water at the brook Cherith. And when the brook dried up and the bird failed to show up, God directed Elijah to arise. My God, I'm getting happy and I don't need to do that right now. To arise and go down to Zarephath, that he might be blessed by a widow woman who would sustain him. And in the process of sustaining him, Elijah would bless her and her house. Get God from Zion. Elijah lived in the house with this woman and her child for an unknown period of time. Strangely, glad it didn't happen in our day, but despite human nature, there is no record of anybody bearing gossip concerning him staying in her house. Well, that's another story. Let me get on with my message. After 3.5 years, God moved upon Elijah to return to Ahab's kingdom and demand that he and his prophets meet him on Mount Carmel. There, Elijah challenged his prophets and the people and all the people with a profound question, which is recorded in 1 Kings 18 and 21. He said, "How long halt ye between two opinions? If the Lord be God," my God. I said, "If the Lord be God, follow him. But if Baal, then follow him." And this is something that caught my attention as I studied. It said, "And the people answered him not a word." Now, the reason that the people didn't answer Elijah is because they were guilty of sin. Oh, come on, somebody. Elijah knew what was going on in the hearts of the people. They were pretending to worship the living and true God, but they were also worshiping Baal. It is that type of double talk. Y'all ain't gonna help me. Two-faced way of living that even today has become so sickening to God that it is a stench in his nostrils. Y'all don't have to like me. The double living standards of so many Christians today makes other folk that are not in the church be turned off by the church. I'm gonna get out of here alive. We sometimes turn them off because we pray neutron bomb prayer. I can't get no help. We pray on Sundays, but we live firecracker lives Monday through Saturday. I can't get no help. I can't get no help. Come on now. Lord, let me leave y'all alone. Let me get back to the people of the Bible. But then I just say this.